Hello, this is the BioBubble Aquatic. If you've already purchased the product, this is what it should look like. I'm going to go ahead and start opening it and getting all the contents ready for setup. Today I'm going to show you exactly how to set up this aquatic unit as an aquarium. This is your filtration kit. Inside are the contents of your air pump, your water pump, and your dome gasket, everything that you need to keep your unit watertight and functioning properly. This is your dome with the beautiful 360 degree views and also the cap that it comes with that's got air vents in it. Is the base of your unit. This accordion shape is what we call the bellows system. It expands your unit as well as providing biological filtration, which is vital for the inhabitants of your aquarium. All right. I'm going to start by opening this up. In here, you'll find your instruction sheet. One side is your setup and operation as an aquarium, which is what we're going to be focusing on today. This is your air pump, and it comes with one media filter. This is your water pump, and it also comes with its own set of instructions. As well as the plastic bag with your filtration gasket and your grease, which is extremely important. We're just going to set this off to the side right now. This is your air tubing and your valve to control your air pump and the flow. And this is your dome gasket and the instructions for that. You need to make sure that this gets installed, otherwise your unit will not be watertight and you will have leaking. Also has its own set of instructions. And last but not least, you'll see that you're gonna come with four clips. You can just put these off to the side because they are not necessary for setup as an aquatic unit. Okay, so first, as you're reading your instructions, you're gonna see the installation instructions for your dome gasket. This is your dome gasket. It has two sides. One side has a slit, and the other side has just kind of a shallow groove. You're gonna wanna make sure that you place your dome upside down in front of you, and that the side of the dome gasket that has the slit is placed over the inside edge of your dome, this edge right here. And you want to make sure that either side of this slit fits securely around that edge. And as you get it on there, you want to slowly work it all the way around the edge of your dome. Making sure that it's pressed down firmly so that it provides a secure fit. And it will also make it watertight. It should fit tightly, so you may have to, pull it a little bit in order to get it on there. And this is what it should look like when it's completely on correctly. You'll see that there should be a small gap in between your gasket and the edge of your dome. That means that it's installed correctly. As an extra measure, you can go around and you can push this down all the way around just to make sure it's on there securely. This is all set. You can just set that off to the side. The next thing is installing your water pump. Go ahead and bring this. You're going to notice that the inside of your unit comes with this cap right here. You're going to run and remove it and just set it off to the side because you won't need it. This is where your water pump is going to be placed. We're going to take that plastic bag that has your O-ring with the grease, and we're going to need to open that up. Personally, I find it easier to kind of leave it inside of the plastic and just kind of move it around inside of the plastic, but you can do it the other way too, where you pull it out and you just kind of make sure that the whole thing is completely lubricated well, because this is what provides your watertight seal for your water pump. And gradually work it all the way around. So your O-ring then is placed inside of this groove, and then just press firmly down to make sure that it's in there securely. This is your water pump. Now that we have the O-ring installed with the grease well lubricated, we're gonna run this cord through the hole in the base. Pull the cord out to the side and keep running the cord through. There's only one way that your water pump will fit in here correctly. You'll feel when it goes in there right, but you want to probably take a look at your base as you're inserting your water pump to make sure that it looks exactly as follows here. And then what you're going to want to do is lay it back down, and you need to twist it clockwise, and it's going to hear a click just like that. That's when you know that you have it in correctly and it's a watertight seal. Now that that's done, we can go ahead and attach our air pump. You can set this off to the side. This is just an extra media filter. You'll want to replace those about every 2 to 4 weeks as your tank runs. This is your air pump. And then this is the tubing that has to attach to the air pump along with the control valve. This is your control valve, and this is your tubing. You'll need to cut this tube in half because your control valve will have to sit right in the middle of it and attach at either end. Once you have that cut in half, you can take your control valve out and you can attach one end of your tubing to the end of the control valve. and you want to try to push that tubing as far on there as you possibly can to make sure that it's on there well. If you can get it to push all the way to the end, that's great, but as long as your tubing is covering this nodule here, you're in good shape. And then you do it to the same thing to the other side. Push it all the way on there as tightly as you can, as far on there. Sometimes it helps if you twist it as you're pushing it. Okay, so that's on there now. Now what we need to do is we need to attach this end of the tube here to the bottom of your water pump right here. And sometimes it takes a little bit of pushing to get it on there because it is a very tight fit. And you want this to really push all the way as far on as you can possibly get it to make sure that it doesn't come loose. So sitting like that is a good position. And then you want to grab your cord and your tubing, flip this down, make sure that you're not setting your unit where there isn't a groove, because otherwise you're going to end up squishing your cords and your tubing. And that's especially important once this is filled with water, that you always keep your cords in one of these grooves. Now we want to go and we want to attach our other end of our tubing to our air pump. And again, get that on there as tightly as you can, just like that. Your valve has an arrow on it. This will control the flow of the air bubbles and the airflow in your unit. If you turn it directly towards your unit, that's the optimal position, but you can adjust it to your liking. Some fish prefer more of an airflow than others. All right, now it's time to place your dome on top of your base. At this point, you want to open up your clamps while this is open, never when this is down. You always want to have your bellows up when your clamps are open. Otherwise, you run a risk of breaking your clamps. So you open them all as far as they'll go, and you place your dome right on top. And it should sit there securely, and it should fit on there so that you can easily clamp all four sides without any undue stress. If your dome gasket isn't installed correctly, it will be extremely difficult for you to close these clamps, and that's one indicator of that not being installed properly. Now, once you have this all set, and your clamps are closed, you can go ahead and push this down and close it up. You can place your cap on. And if you ordered a light cap, then you can obviously pop this out. This pushes right out in the center, and you can install your cap light straight through here. And the cap light does come with its own set of instructions, and you can watch that video separately. Your cap is on and you are ready to add water and fish.
Cool.
Okay, so now that you have your unit set up, when you are ready to start adding water and letting it cycle through, getting ready to push your fish in, to open this, you're gonna want to push in on both of these tabs. There's one here and there's one here. If you just pinch them and pull up, your bellows will expand and your unit becomes larger. At this point then, you open your clamps, remove your dome, set it off to the side, and you have open wide access to your unit so you can add water. And you'll want to let your unit cycle for at least, I would say, 2 weeks before adding any fish to make sure that the biological filtration is correct and all your water parameters are where they need to be, depending on whether you're doing salt water or fresh water. Once you start adding water, you'll only want to bring your water up until it hits just under this rim. Thank you.